Hello friends, welcome to lesson 14 on batch scripting. In this lesson, we will continue talking about arrays. If you guys haven't checked my previous video on batch scripting, I will highly recommend you guys to go and check that out. The link will be in the description. So today we are discussing about modifying an array and iterating over an array. So let's start with modifying an array. So suppose we want to add an element to the end of the array. So for that, we can use the set command along with the last index of the array element that's known to us. So let me show you how to do that. So at the rate echo off to stop the echoing, pause to hold the screen, rem for remark, and let's say we are using modifying an array. You can use anything what you want here in the remark, that's up to you. So now we have to create an array. To do so, you have to use the set command. So here 0 is the index and 1 is the value that is assigned to this position. So let's duplicate that and change the index. So if you want to add an element to the end of the array, we have to use the set command again, and we should know the index, last index of the array. So here 2 is there, so this one, to add a new one, so the index will be 3 here and the value say 4. Now print that, the last element in the array, let's say array A of 3. Oh my, sorry for that. A of 3 equal to, yep, and save that. Create a bat executable file here. Let's say file.bat. So here the output should be, the last element in the array is 4, because A of 3 has value 4 in it. So let's see that. That you can see the last element in the array 4. You can also modify an existing element of an array by using assigning a new value at a given index. So if I want to change the value at index, suppose let's say 1, so right now it is having value 2, I want to change it to 4. So I have changed it to 4 and let's print that. So it should print last element in the array 4. So double click, it says last element in the array 4. Yeah, so that was all about modifying an array. So let's go for the other one, iterating over an array. Let's use that. Iterating over an array is achieved by using the for loop and going through each element of the array. So let's see that. So let me show you. Set local, that says enable delayed expansion. This will cause variables within a batch file to be expanded at the execution time rather than at the pass time. This option is turned on with the set local enable delayed expansion command. Expansion is performed each time the line is executed or for each loop in a for loop command. So that's why we are using that. Let's create, assign a array. Let's say here arr index 0 is equal to, let's say 1, and duplicate that multiple times. That's fine. 1, 2, 3 and 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now to iterate, we have to use the for loop. So let's use the for loop for slash L. Slash L is used to iterate through the array or a range of numbers. So slash L will tell the loop that we have to iterate through an array or a range of numbers. You can use any variable here. I'm using x in, let's say 0, from 0 increment by 1 up to 4. What to do? Print that echo arr. I mean, I have used x, so I have to use x and close the braces, and yeah. So the output of this should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's see that. So I think we haven't closed the loop. No, it's fine. Let's see that. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 has been printed. So here, each element of the array needs to be specified using the set command. And the for loop within the L parameter for moving through the range is used to iterate through an array or a range of numbers. So that was all for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. In the next video, we will continue talking about arrays. Till then, stay tuned, stay connected, and thanks for watching the video.